One of the arguments I hear often against eating meat is that meat is unhealthy because it rots in your colon. We are not built for eating meat, we're not designed to eat meat, and the meat is in our digestive tract for too long and it rots in the colon and can lead to cancer and all sorts of other problems. In this video, I'm going to tell you what happens to meat and I'm going to tell you what happens in your colon. Welcome to ShapeFixer. I'm Andrew. I'm a nutritionist and a trained biologist. What happens to meat when you eat it? Meat is made of protein and fat, predominantly. Right, so the protein portion of the meat, when it gets into your stomach, it dissolves, it breaks down in your stomach acid. That is the primary function of your stomach acid, is to break the protein down into amino acids, which are the little molecular building blocks of protein. Those amino acids then leave your stomach, they go into your small intestine, and from there they are absorbed into your bloodstream. So they're gone, that's it, the protein's done. The fat portion of the meat moves through your stomach into your small intestine, and then in the presence of bile, which is released by your gallbladder, the fat breaks down into fatty acids, and they too are absorbed into your bloodstream. As much as you need. If there's any left, it just passes on through. So by the time anything reaches your colon, if you have eaten way more fat than you need, which is unlikely because you have hormones that will discourage you from doing that because you start to not like the taste. But if you do, then some of those fatty acids will reach your colon and that'll be fine. The protein's not there. There's certainly no meat in your colon, absolutely nothing. So what does happen in your colon? Well, what else do we eat? Apart from meat or protein and fat, the only other major food group, if you can call it that, is carbohydrates or sugar, usually in the form of starch. That starts to break down in your mouth even before it reaches your stomach. Amylase, which is the enzyme that breaks starch down into glucose, starts acting as you are chewing your starch. So your pasta, your potatoes, your bread. You then swallow that, and it continues in your stomach, and by the time that gets to your small intestine, the glucose has been liberated and that is absorbed into your blood. So that doesn't make it to the colon either. So what's left? Fiber. That's what's left. The fibrous, non-digestible part of your plant meal. That goes into your colon. And what happens in your colon? Your colon is full of microbes. Bacteria, fungi, viruses. And their job is to break down what's left, which mostly they use for food for themselves. And the process of microbes breaking down any kind of food substance, that's what we call rotting. That's their job. So yes, rotting goes on in your colon because your microbes are breaking stuff down in your colon. But it's not meat. It's not the meat that's rotting in your colon. It's the vegetables. It's okay because it's supposed to do that. So it's nothing to worry about. But it's certainly, there is no rotten meat in your colon. Thank you for your time. Thank you for subscribing to our channel. Don't miss any of our upcoming videos.